The Data Generation tool by Devart can help you to quickly and easily populate your database with thousands of rows of coherent, realistic data for testing purposes. Data Generator can both work as a standalone tool and be launched internally in the SQL Server Management Studio. First, just select the database you want to populate with data. Then you'll see a dialog with the Open Projects properties, which allows you setting up a connection in the initial options. Imagine you're writing your application, and the first thing you do is creating a bunch of tables which you want to fill with data that resembles real-world data. Of course, you could type all that data by hand, but as you can guess, that's going to be extremely time-consuming and tedious. So to avoid doing unnecessary work, you can just delegate the process to the data generation tool. dbForge Data Generator analyzes your database schema and automatically selects appropriate generators for each column based on the column name, data type, constraints, and other parameters. As a result, it cleverly associates a column with an appropriate generator. You can see the first 50 rows in the Preview of Data to be Generated pane. Data from the last name column will be filled from the last name dictionary. If a check constraint is assigned to a column, the tool analyzes it and generates data that will satisfy the constraint's expression. By default, the regular expression generator creates US-like addresses, but we can let it generate UK-like addresses instead. The customer photo column will be populated with small JPEG pictures. You can also manually tune any generator that was automatically assigned to a column. As you can see, the generated data looks very coherent and realistic. dbForge Data Generator automatically controls referential integrity for linked tables. When a child column is a part of a relationship, it will by default load data from the parent column in the parent table. It also correctly handles multi-column foreign key constraints. Let's say you want each order to contain from 1 to 5 order lines. To do it, you should just enable the Repeat Each Value checkbox and set the correspondent number to 5. As a result, the order number 108 will contain 3 order lines. Because our database is still in a developing state, there is no foreign key assigned between customers.customerID and orders.customerID. But it's not an issue for the data generation tool, so you can manually assign the relationship. Just replace its generator with foreign key manually assigned and choose the customer table. After that, the customer ID column will be chosen automatically. We want the tool to generate an order date that is no older than a month, with the shipping date not being more than 10 days since the order has been placed. To implement this logic, we would first need to tweak the options of the order date column. Set its range as offset from now, choose use offset details, and then set min to negative 30 and max to negative 10 days. For the ship date column, we should set the range as offset from column, choose order date column, and set min to 0 and max to 10 days. Okay, now we'll need to tune the default email generator. You have to do the following steps to generate email addresses based on the first name and the last name from the corresponding columns. Firstly, you need to clear the regular expression editor. Then you need to type dot, choose the last name column, and finally type @nomail.com. Now, let's populate the database. By default, the tool executes the data population script against the database, but in this case, we want to review the script in SSMS and execute it later. To execute the population list, just hit F5. Just download a 30-day free trial of the data generator and find out how easy and painless data generation can be.